But Father God, we just want to thank you. We want to thank you again that you are a God that hears and sees and looks upon the heart, Lord, that you know the intentions of our heart. And even though we have good intentions outside of following our heart, you know, that is what you look at. At times we are confused, we're distracted, we don't know which way to go. But Father, you said that your word we should hide in our heart that we may not sin against you. And if we have that intention on our heart, if we have that word hidden in our heart, we will have no issue. Have no issue to follow the directions that you give us. So Father, even as we open our word one more time, I pray that this word will be an encouragement. And I feel like God is just you're sharing something with us that will continue to be in the same vein, so that when the others come back on, that we'll just continue in that conversation. Father, have your will, have your way. And we just want to thank you again for today and your word. So this morning, I just wanted to look into the scriptures, looking at 1 Peter. In 1 Peter, you know, we are introduced to looking at how we as believers should be living, how we should equip ourselves. And most importantly, when Peter is sharing with us, he's sharing from his experience of walking as a Christian, walking with Christ, and the journey that he had to go through, the turmoil that he had to go through his time of living with Christ, as well as witnessing to the gift of the gospel that Christ was on the earth after he departed, after his resurrection. After his ascension, Peter was still speaking of the goodness of Christ while he was here. And in Peter, Jesus is also referred to as the chief shepherd. So as the chief shepherd, we know that the shepherd is there to watch over the flock. And as he's watching over the flock, he's in a place where he has the responsibility to fight. Not only to bring them to water and make sure they have to eat, but to make sure that he fights for us on our behalf when we have struggles, when we are faced with temptations. The shepherd is going to make sure that we are safe, and so it's our responsibility as sheep to follow the shepherd and go where he takes us. And another reason we call it chief shepherd is because that there's also shepherds among us. That we, as we had the bishop online, as we had the pastor online, as we had the evangelists online, there are also those among us who have the responsibility to shepherd the flock that is here as well. And in that, that we are always have to be willing to sacrifice, to battle on behalf of our brothers and sisters as well. And that sometimes comes in opportunities of prayer meeting where we're interceding for others. Of course, the most important thing, that when we get to a place of intercession, we want to be in a place where our prayers would be received. I'm saying all of that to say this, that when we look at living a godly life, there's an expectation that God has for us for obedience. And I think the evangelist was sharing about that earlier as I came on. So we're just going to look at 1 Peter chapter 4, and we're going to read the first few verses. And it says, "Therefore, since Christ suffered in body, arm yourselves also with the same attitude. Because wherever suffering is in the body is done with sin." I'll read that one more time. "Therefore, since Christ suffered in body, arm yourself also with the same attitude. Because wherever suffering in the body is done with sin. As a result, they do not live the rest of their earthly lives for sin and human desires, but rather for God. For you have spent enough time in the past doing what pagans choose to do, living debauchery, lust, drunkenness, orgies, and detestable idolatry. There are surprises that you do not join them in reckless. They are surprised, sorry, that you do not join them in recklessness while living, and they heap abuse on you. But they will have to give account to him who is ready to judge the living and the dead. For this reason, the gospel was preached even though those who are now dead, so the mighty be judged according to the human standards in regards to the body, but live also to God in regards to spirit. Okay, so let me just sum that up quickly as we go through. Peter is giving an example of how we should be living as believers. There is a challenge that we have, to get to a place where we are willing to suffer in the body, so that we can be dead to sin. We are mind, body, and spirit. And if we had to let one of those go, which one are we willing to go to suffer the most in order to elevate ourselves in other spaces? We have to get to a place where we are willing to elevate our desire, elevate our commitment to being spiritual beings. There is that battle between the flesh and the battle between the spirit. And so the victory will come in arming ourselves with the same attitude that Christ had. Amen. So that same attitude that Christ had, he was willing to do whatever the Father asked of him, even if it meant going through physical pain or physical restrictions. There are things that are not healthy for us physically, and that is going to have a impact on us spiritually. So I'm asking you today, as we just are going through, as you're going through this time of a prayer and fasting, what is it in my body? What is it that I am doing that might be restricting my spiritual growth? We have to be in a place where we can recognize that God has given us the example. He gave us the gift of Jesus, who was both the Lamb and the chief shepherd. He showed us how it is to serve and also how it is to lead. He has shown us that if we can get to a place where we are willing to suffer somewhat in our body, whether it's sacrificing for others, giving love to our brother, sacrificing the gifts that he has given us, using those gifts that he has given us to empower our brothers and sisters to serve him the way that he served us, to love our brothers the way that he served us, that we will get to a higher elevation in our spiritual walk. You see, the chains that are holding us back are generally ones that are ones that are about self-pleasure. What is it about my body? What is it that I am trying to accomplish? Those are the chains that are holding us back from getting to a higher spiritual place with God. We have to get to a place where we are saying, whatever it is that you ask me to do, Lord, I am going to do it. And chains are there to restrict us and to hold us back. So sometimes we have tendencies. In the scripture, we talked about debauchery, living, lust, drunkenness, orgies, all these things that come in front of us. And for some of us that have been in the walk, the Christian walk, it could be as simple as Peter talks about gossip, about backbiting, about how we interact with others. There are different levels of righteousness that God is calling us to, different levels of his glory that he wants to show us, but we have to break the chains of our behaviors, those things that are our fleshly responses to our everyday living, getting vexed with this person or telling off that person or gossiping about that person. These are all things that we already know, but it's part of our godly living that God is trying to elevate us to the place where he can use us. You see, Peter knows about being used by God. He is reminding us that he went all the way to jail. He was locked up. He was locked up for preaching the gospel. He was locked up because he could not let that spiritual part of him be bound. That spiritual gift that God has given him, he didn't want it to be bound up. So he continued to move forward and share and use the gift that God has given him. In the process of that, his body ended up dealing with some restrictions. His body ended up dealing with some suffering. His body went up all the way to where he was placed in prison. And the restriction would imagine, or we would think that that might be the end of the story for him. He's locked up in jail, ready to be killed. He had seen some of his other brothers be killed earlier than this. And most of us have not had to face this type of persecution in this day and time, but are we willing to go through the uncomfortable feelings of sharing God's good news with those who need it? Are we comfortable with going through the uncomfortable feelings sometime of going and taking love and sharing it with the people that most would not want to be accompanied with? That is what Jesus showed us an example to us. Oh, the smells that come off of some people. Oh, the words that come out of some people's mouth. Oh, the behaviors that they continue to practice. That is a lifestyle that they are in. But until we come and use that gift that God has given us to show them the way, to show them love, they may not change from the place where they are. So we have to be in a place where we're willing to go through the sacrifices, where we are willing to put our body in front of harm's way, if it means putting forward our spiritual self and showing, being a reflection of the light that God has called us to be. Even though Peter went through that situation where he was locked up, it was the Spirit of God. It was the Spirit of God that sent an angel that caused him to become free. He was able to walk through all of the soldiers that were detaining him. And he was able to get to a place where his spiritual strength, his spiritual obedience allowed him to get victory in the physical places, not only for himself, but for others. Others that hear the word that you have put forward will be elevated because you have been obedient. God is looking for us, looking for children that are willing to be shepherds, looking for children that are willing to be obedient to the call that he had, looking for children who are going to be willing to continue to move his victory and his process forward, his kingdom forward, so that they would also be joint heirs with Christ, joint heirs with him, so that sin would be done in our life and we can be a reflection of him. Help us, Lord God, in places where we are struggling to let go. Help us, Lord God, in places where we are struggling to say that we are not willing to release that to you, in our confessions, in our repentance, in our lifestyles, in our relationships, in our service to the King and to his kingdom, in the churches, in the streets, wherever you place us, Lord God. I pray that you would allow us to not be afraid to go through some struggles and some pains physically and emotionally, if it means strengthening our spirit and getting us to a place where sin would be dead in our lives and we would be called or seen to be worthy to be used by you. Brothers and sisters, I pray that as you just continue to go through this time of prayer and fasting, know that as we strengthen ourselves in the Lord, strengthen ourselves in the word, strengthen ourselves in times of prayer, that the chains will truly be broken off and nothing will be able to hold us if we're walking in the Spirit of God and what he has called us to be. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.